The Rangers then decided to track down Sledge with Coda's heightened sense of smell. Meanwhile, Sledge found Madame Odious, and the two were spotted by the Blue Rangers. The two were having an exchange in who gets to have the Ranger keys. After examining the Ranger keys, Madame Odious sees potential in forming her own minions. She tells Sledge she will fix his ship with her Nylot magic if Sledge is able to retrieve all the rest of the Ranger keys. Sledge wants to have all the Ranger keys to himself and decides to trick Madame Odious in fixing his ship while he took the other half of it, saying he will use it to find a way to destroy the Rangers. He examined the 6 Ranger keys. Sledge tests out the never-seen-before Indigo key in his Gigantify Beam device repurposed as a teleporter. It teleported a person there, and Madame Odious found the coordinates of that person. She headed there to see if it will be a friend or foe. She and Tinymon found Heckle, who was battling Neo-Nilox. Before Heckle was about to morph, she immediately steps in and corrupts him, the same way she did to Levi before. Madame Odious says she is able to unleash the inner darkness of a person, so it's not fully mind control yet. Now, Heckle is under his Snide persona again, and Sledge orders him to use his Heckle persona to retrieve the Ranger keys with him. While the Rangers are on the hunt on Sledge, Redbot tells the Rangers there is a new person in this dimension. They found Heckle, who pretends that he is helping the Rangers, fooling Coda as well. The team splits up, Coda and Levi will bring him back to the base, as the rest of the team continue to hunt. Preston uses his magic to duplicate Coda's sense of smell for the other Rangers, which is a joke. Everyone is disgusted by each other's odor, and they call each other out that they need to have baths. They explain the situation to Heckle, and he secretly wants to take the Ranger keys for Sledge. Levi notices something is wrong, quickly intervenes, and the two broke out into a fight. Heckle accidentally trips and drops all the Ranger keys into the teleporter, teleporting all the rest of the Dino Charge Rangers and Gold Ranger. Snide, finally revealing himself, decides it will be better to just steal the Ener Gems from the Rangers. While Kodas chases Snide as he went to the coordinates, the Dino Charge Rangers arrived at the same time. Snide reaches the Rangers first and asks them to hand over their Ener Gems to help them leave this mess. But Coda arrives and jumps in front of the Rangers. Coda explained Heckle isn't Heckle, he's under the Snide persona. Adam and Boom quickly did some analysis and figured out how to turn Heckle back to normal. Boom said there is a huge darkness of evil energem in Heckle now. Adam asked if they could synthesize some sort of energy to reverse it. And then Heckle transforms into the Talon Ranger. Dino Charge Rangers morphs alongside with Levi as the Gold Ranger and fights Snide. With the Talon Ranger's weapon and fighting style, there were no match against Heckle. Heckle easily cleans the floor with the Rangers, and the Rangers barely kept up, even with Levi's help. So Levi created a diversion, ninja style, and helped them retreat. Levi and Coda brought the Dino Charge Rangers up to speed about the events of this crossover episode. Turns out, Levi had placed a tracking device on Heckle, and it will lead them to Sledge's ship. Riley suggested that they should follow Heckle and start tracking the other Rangers from there. Back on Sledge's ship, Sledge berated Snide for teleporting the other Dino Charge Rangers there. The two team of Rangers sneaked into Sledge's ship in pairs as they fought Neo Moogers in the way guarding it. Brody and Tyler were teamed up together, both showing they are similarly hot-headed and excited. Riley and Haley teamed up together. Riley figured out this is like a maze and decides to use his intellect to solve pathways. Haley used her sense of direction to guide them. Shelby and Sarah are together. Shelby is headstrong and Sarah is intelligent. The two often butted heads, but they're able to work together as a team as they battle against the Neo Moogers. Shelby used her powers to power her way through the Neo Moogers directly. Not what Sarah was thinking, but it solves the problem quickly. Coda and Preston teamed up together, but Preston warns him this place is filled with magic to fool the eyes, so Coda suggested Preston to blindfold their eyes and rely on his sense of smell. Chase and Calvin teamed up together, both are light-hearted jokesters, enjoy each other's company. They hardly got any work done, easily took out Neo Moogers, but they were the first to figure out this to be a trap. Heckle knew there was a tracking device, and he let the Rangers follow him there. Most of the Rangers, except Coda and Preston, finally found the rest of the Ranger keys. Chase and Calvin tried to warn the Rangers, but they were too late. They were also captured alongside with the other Rangers. These Rangers were held as hostages, while Preston and Coda found the rest of the real Ranger keys and left Sledge's ship. Sledge then gave an announcement that the two were given a chance to hand over the Ranger keys, or the rest of the Rangers will be destroyed. They have an hour to decide, and they will meet by the quarry. Preston and Coda retreated back to Adam's base. Adam said they have figured out a way to solve it and discussed the plan. In Sledge's message, Coda noticed that Sledge has placed all the Rangers' energems in a satchel. An hour later, Preston and Coda arrived at the quarry while Sledge is waiting with the hostages. Sledge demands the two to hand over the keys. Slowly, Coda held the keys in the bag over to Sledge. As he reaches for the keys, Preston takes out his ninja steel sword and slices the satchel off Sledge's hilt and kicked it up into the sky. As the energems were in the sky, from afar, Adam with a ninja steel blaster blasted the satchel. A strong, powerful white light ignited the bag into a powerful, bright explosion. Preston used his magic and flung the energems in a circle, creating a powerful, blinding white light. and knock everyone off their feet, including Snide. Snide writhed in agony as the essence of evil has been destroyed in Heckle. Madam Odious tried to use the darkness spell on Heckle again, but the white light was so strong, Snide was vanquished. Heckle quickly grabbed the energems and the ninja stars as he freed the rangers. The rangers ran to Preston and Coda's side. While Heckle was passing the energems back to the rangers, Heckle found a bright energem formed from the darkness. And it is time. The rangers finally morphed into the full team of Ninja Steel and Power Ranger, Dino Charge, with the newest toy product. The newest member, Dino Charge Talon Ranger of Good. We see a spectacular battle with Madam Odious. Sledge's crew and new Moogers against their Ninja Steel and Dino Charge Rangers. After crushing the Neo Moogers, the Dino Charge Rangers fought against Sledge's crew as the Ninja Steel Rangers faced off against Sledge. Heckle, Levi, and Ivan fought against Madam Odious. Sledge and his crew were knocked out by the Dino Charges and Ninja Steel's final strike. Madam Odious was taken out after Ivan sent a lightning final strike. While Heckle threw his boomerang at Madam Odious and Levi impaled her, Madam Odious revealed she has confiscated a few Dino Charge Spinozord batteries and summoned the Spinozord. Sledge summons a few Skulligators and Dino Charge Talon Zord under Sledge's control. The Dino Steel and Dino Charge Rangers summon their Zords. As the Skulligators were easily cut down by the Ninja Steel Rangers, the Dino Charge Rangers were having difficulties fighting against the Spinal Megazord. The Ninja Steel Rangers tries to step in and help, but they were unsuccessful. Heckle decides he will go and fight against Sledge, but Madam Odious is strong enough to step in. Levi and Ivan tells the rest of the Rangers to go and help Heckle, as they are able to handle the Zord themselves. Finally, Sledge was defeated and he drops the batteries. Heckle retrieves the batteries and Madam Odious has to retreat. The Rangers were successful and returned back to their base with the Ranger keys. They were able to contact Miss Morgan, as the Rangers were battling. Miss Morgan, Boom, Redbot, and Adam work together to calibrate the teleporter, so the Rangers can send the Dino Charge team to their battle world and win their war. The Rangers said their goodbyes. While Sledge hangs his head low as he retreats with his crew, Madam Odious has fixed his ship. As she said, Sledge has given her something more than enough as he leaves. When Sledge and his crew departs, Madam Odious revealed when Sledge crash landed, there were traces of Ninja Steel used as scrap metal on the part of his ship, something that will be very useful for her. She forged a blade out of the hammer she uses to merge Neo Moogers with Ninja Steel stars. As the season continues, the Rangers realize all the Ninja stars are energized. Ripcon also gained a new power-up when Madam Odious presented him with Levi's Yusumaru sword. Galvanax decide it is time to be serious and met with Madam Odious again. They sent in Ripcon and another powerful opponent. With a newfound body and power, Ripcon acted like a child and he was easily beaten by the Rangers. In the next battle, Sarah planned a trap with ninja stars laid out in the open to lure out Ripcon and even Galvanax, despite Adam thinking it is too much of a risky move, as Ripcon is a wild card. The Rangers said it is a risk they're willing to take, as they will use the powers of ninja stars to take out Ripcon once and for all. The Rangers were badly defeated, and all the ninja stars were taken by Ripcon, who was surprisingly very powerful. He was pretending to be weak the entire time. Ripcon was able to take all the ninja stars and present it to Galvanax. But turns out, the red ninja star was missing. Ripcon took it upon himself to challenge Brody again. He said if Brody defeats Ripcon, he will return back the morphing ninja stars and Zord stars. Brody learned not to face off against Ripcon alone. Thus with Boom's help, the two fought in the line of fire armor. Trying to redeem herself, Sarah decided for a new plan and laid out a trap to take out Ripcon. As Brody is fighting one-on-one against Ripcon, the other ninja rangers infiltrated to the guarded ninja stars that is held in a stand next to the duel, disguised as the foot soldiers. But they were easily discovered, so they had to fight unmorphed against the Neo-Nylock lieutenant, bringing them further away from the ninja stars. Meanwhile in the duel, Ripcon was able to get the upper hand against Brody and knocked him out of morph. When Ripcon was about to deliver a killing blow, Brody threw his red morphing ninja star at Ripcon, and Ripcon struck the star which created an explosion. The explosion was so strong, Ripcon was sent falling to his feet. When he turned around, the Ninja Rangers received their ninja stars back in the stand. The Neo-Nylock lieutenant has been fighting against the illusions created by the Rangers, making him move away from protecting the ninja stars. Sarah heads in first, making this personal, when straight up beating up Ripcon as the other Rangers fought against the Neo-Nylock lieutenant. Sarah used her rage, knocking Levi's Yusumaru out of Ripcon's hand, and started to wield it like dual blade style. Distracted by her fight against Ripcon, Calvin commented that they should never make Sarah angry. With the power of the Yusumaru, Sarah single-handedly took out Ripcon as the other Rangers defeated the lieutenant. But before Ripcon died, he ran and grabbed the Yusumaru. When the two Neo-Nylocks died, both their second lives kicked in. The team summoned their Megazord, but Sarah Kara is missing in the Shinobi Megazord. Turns out, she took the other Rangers' Ninja Steel Zords to control by herself. Sarah quickly eyed the weakness of Ripcon, told the Rangers to knock the sword out of Ripcon's hand, as it is the source of Ripcon's existence. After a tough battle, Levi slammed Ripcon's sword out of his hand and Sarah defeated the lieutenant. Sarah said she is done messing around and it kinda scared the other Rangers. The three ninja stars were dropped when the monsters were destroyed and Sarah picked them up. Brody noticed that his ninja star has two cracks on it from the impact of the Yuzumaru. When returning back to the food truck, the Rangers had a briefing about everyone's bravery. Even their auxiliary swords are still with the villains. While waiting for their mentors to arrive, Sarah held her ninja coin next to the three ninja stars they had collected. After being energized, they were blank. Brody explained it might be a spare ninja star just in case if the old ones broke. While getting a drink, Calvin found a note on the table. Turns out, Adam and Boom were kidnapped by Galvanax.